Xong trình quỳ. Chim to ông nhóm ra xong chơi lúc mình thử vi ca phí lúc mình chia tăng xâm nguồn lưu xạ xây lúc này hãy lúc mình thử vi rùm chàng mình thử vi ca phí đây lúc hiện xong phó mình là dạ phí lúc này thằng ngày xa vào nà ca xong chơi lúc mình thử vi ca phí lúc mình chia
Thank you, Mr. President.
Good afternoon.
Do you recall what you did before 1975? What was your work? Were you at one point assigned as a messenger
to work
with the Khmer Rouge? I will get to that. You said were you before 1975 a messenger for the later chief of the Northwest Zone
near
Runim or
Tanim that ye pretend Kang Pum Pier be your diary
day?
You briefly mentioned already events after 75. Sometime in 1976, Tanim invited you to be his bodyguard. And were you Tanim's bodyguard until the day that he was arrested? How many bodyguards, including yourself, did Runim have between 75 and 1978? And were you one of the three that were close to him?
Look, chia kong ka pi ma neak knong chnao 3 neak dai neu chop kwat dai ru te?
Ot de.
Well, let me get back to that, but first,
before
coming to that, do you recall any other of the three bodyguards
that
Runim had?
Kong ka pia nam a neak nung chan naom kong ka pia tang bay dai nơi chop chumoy nung ru nhum dai ru te?
Nhum wat cham o nung bay yuwa nung nung lai chop kok nơi nung klik phiang o cham tu.
Before I turn to your tasks as bodyguard,
let me ask you about messengers
who also used to work for Runim, Tanim.
Do
you recall a messenger with the name of Chiruk? Was he a messenger or was he rather a bodyguard?
Quan nong chia ni ra sai ru ko chia kong ka pia.
Ke jiap ko chnik vo nong. Nong ko ka pia kra phu nyom phseing. Sau na tau chngai chngai nyom.
Do you know another person who used to be a
squall
courier,
manu,
a messenger,
not only for
maybe also Nuon Chia,
named
Tali, alias
Tali, Takim. Squall day.
Hon. Đại khơi nhu hông?
No problem. Let me now turn to your tasks as bodyguard
for Chief of the Northwest Sun, Runim.
What were your daily tasks?
Could you give us a description?
What when it turned wrong, I got the throw car to another, but how so? Namanto, not the line. For a young sake, got another chant the lantern.
In one of your three WRIs, you said that you escorted and secured Runim's safety everywhere he went. Is that correct? If he was going to nearby places, was it then someone else of the two bodyguards
that
secured his safety?
No.
Can you tell us where you live during the period that you were the bodyguard? Is it correct that you stayed in a house about 50 meters from
Ampel Prahong?
And is it correct that Ruhnim's house and his working office was at Ampel Prahong? And is it correct that Ampel Prahong the office of
Ampel Prahong ni keu chea menti ka ngia menti thua ka ngia roba Ruhnim
kilometer west
hai pteh roba Ruhnim
market in Battambang town
sthat neu chamngai prahai chea 1 kilomet pi phsa leu knong khaet Battambang
tam trau.
And can you tell us a bit
how
things would go if you were to drive him to certain places? What would you do? Would you walk from
ទៅកាពីគាត់ពីកន្លែងមួយទៅកន្លែងមួយតើបានន័យថាលោកដើរពីផ្ទះលោកទៅកាន់ផ្ទះគាត់ទៅដល់អំពើប្រហោងហើយរងចាំគាត់រហូតដល់គាត់ចេញមកហើយទើបទៅឬយ៉ាងម៉េចតើលោកអាចរៀបរាប់អំពីចំណុចហ្នឹងដែរឬទេបាទចាញ់បានយ៉ាងទៅតែពីដល់ជួបគាត់ហ្នឹងបានទៅមិនដែរបាត់ចាំយូរទេ.
What was your car at your at or was Ruhnim's car
at your house or was his car
at Ampel Prahong? Can you tell me
what the situation was?
And what kind of car was it that used when you were driving him?
And
were responsible for his safety? And was it this Jeep, this white Jeep that you used all the time that you were his bodyguard slash driver from 1976 until his arrest? Were you always using this white Jeep? We talked about Ruhnim's house and office at Ampel Prahong. Where was Tanim's military base? Do you know?
ត្រង់វិលផងនៅជុំវិលផ្ទះគាត់រອບខ្នល់
I understand. But did Tanim also have a military base where he would go to? I'm asking you because you said in your first
was also done in the military.
Is it correct that north of Runim's house was the house of Tapet,
alias
Takantol, number two or number three of the northwest zone? Did you ever bring him to Tapet's house? Is it correct that Tanim held meetings with his military
chiefs?
In your WRI, same one I just mentioned, question 62, you said that you were not allowed to enter the meeting place. Is that correct? And if yes, why was that? I didn't get the answer, but I will get it on the screens soon.
Mr.
Witness, let me move to the arrest of Runim. Where was Runim arrested? Do you remember? Let me see if I can refresh your memory in that same WRI question and answer 13. You said that Runim was arrested in Sisophon while he was trying to I'm a bit puzzled by your answer now.
Mr. Witness,
it was only 3 years ago that you gave testimony to the investigators.
ខ្លួនគាត់នៅស៊ីជប៉ុននៅពេលដែលរស់នៅខ្ញុំគេថាកម្មាភិបាលភូមិភាគនិរតីគឺចាប់ខ្លួនគាត់នៅស៊ីជប៉ុននៅពេលដែលរស់នៅខ្ញុំគេថាកម្មាភិបាលភូមិភាគនិរតីគឺចាប់ខ្លួនគាត់នៅស៊ីជប៉ុននៅពេលដែលរស់នៅខ្ញុំគេថាកម្មាភិបាលភូមិភាគនិរតីគឺចាប់ខ្លួនគាត់នៅស៊ីជប៉ុននៅពេលដែលរស់នៅខ្ញុំគេថាកម្មាភិបាលភូមិភាគនិរតីគឺចាប់ខ្លួនគាត់នៅស៊ីជប៉ុននៅពេលដែលរស់នៅខ្ញុំគេថាកម្មាភិប
There is other evidence from Northwest Son Cadre, who said that he heard helicopters when Rudin was arrested. E3/9578, question and answer 10.
Do you recall the day
when Rudin was arrested? And if yes, did you hear the sounds of helicopters?
Who
told you that Rudin wanted to run or escape to
Kampong Cham
just before his arrest?
Wait a bit. Council cannot follow because he doesn't
have vocations.
They also die on me. I apologize for that. Let me move on, Mr. Witness, to something else.
You saw Rudin practically
every day, I presume, or many times between 1976 and the day of his arrest in 1978. Do you recall their names? And the names were? Was there also a third child, Sihur?
Got mean county by Shmua Sihur there.
Your band, thank God, you were wrong, couldn't get by Bunyat now.
Well, I have the name of Sihur from you from your testimony.
/9581/55.
That's not very important.
But
I am just the oldest son,
Chil.
Do you know if Chil was married, and if yes, to whom?
And if Chil was married, and if yes, to whom? And if Chil
was married, and if yes, to whom?
What was Chil's function? What was his position in the Northwest Zone? Do you know whether Runim had any adopted children or foster children?
Oui, c'est juste une observation parce que dans le canal français, j'entends parfois parler de Hunim.
Et je pense qu'il faut bien être clair, c'est que je parle de Hunim, il y a de Rosnim, de Hunim.
Mais je le dis peut-être plus pour les interprètes, je ne sais pas
ce qu'il est dans le canal.
I'm happy to pronounce it the English. It's my understanding that it's Runim in Khmer, but I'm happy to talk about Rosnim because that's the person that we speak about, and indeed not Hunim.
R-U-O-S-N-H-I-M.
Mr. Witness, did you say that you didn't know whether
Tanim
had any foster children, adopted
children?
You were asked questions about a man, about a person with the name of Ham.
Ham.
In your WRIs, you said that you knew a few Dahams, but did you know any Ham who was close to
Runim?
And who was he? The hum that was close to Runim?
The hum that was close to
Runim?
And the hum that you speak to was he the deputy chief of the general staff of the
Northwest Zone?
And the person that we speak about, is he also known as Tong Tot? Someone who until very recently was a brigadier general in the Royal Cambodian Armed Forces. Someone who died exactly 2 months today.
Yutapol Khmer Phum Mun, how got Bandatu Mona Pihai Taluk đăng thế được dừng như vậy bị bộ cô nâng mang đại thế
on đại khơi đại lấy vốn đại kêu lại vốn
now it comes practical that I, we have a photo
of the mean report some anya pilopathien lopathien khom chong bong hai rup thot dai yeung ban chechek khnie no mon aha thngai trong
khom
mean chbab thot chamlong chran dai prasan ba phiek ki chap arom no keu tha khom achai chut ban khom ko ban banchun tam ja email phong dai lopathien
ong mreh anyat
And with your leave, Mr. President, we can also
so put on the screen. People look at the audience can see the ground and by our satin at you and time down the band curtain.
Some trace out to behind your roof, Tony Tam, the ground to two.
That's the wrong photo.
Batman man look taught and take call high.
AV unit, please.
Khang sao tu, som chak ban chang.
It's a colored photo.
Ku rup thot poa.
It's apparently difficult to get this photo on the screen. Meanwhile, I'll
move on. Mr. Witness, do you know this person? Lok sat say,
On.
No.
Could you now, Councillor, identify him for the record, provided it's not too early for you for strategic reasons?
No, I can do that now. For the record, this is a photo of
a
witness, Ton Tot, who testified before the Supreme Court chamber
in
June 2015. The photo was taken in front of her while he was sitting on that very same chair. Mr. Witness, never seen this person? Well, he has many. He testified in his capacity or his name, Ton Tot. Ton Tot.
ខ្ញុំក៏ពេលតែគាត់មកបញ្ជាក់ដល់សេចក្តីកម្មនៅទីនេះចៅក្រុមប្រហែលជាលោកសូមបញ្ជាក់បានច្បាស់ដោយសារតែវាមានបញ្ហាក្នុងការបកប្រែឈ្មោះនេះចេញខ្ញុំសូមអនុញ្ញាតបញ្ជាក់ឈ្មោះគាត់ឈ្មោះតាត់ធឿន
Thank you. Again, Mr. Witness, you do not recognize the photo, but that
Lok
name is also not familiar to you. Is that correct?
On.
Mr. I will give it one last try, Mr. Witness. He also used another name. Maybe that name is that maybe sound familiar to you. Mr. President, I'll be referring to document E3/1065, 10665. This is a transcript
of an interview that
British filmmaker Robert Lemkin
had with Robert Lemkin, also known as Hum,
or more commonly known as Hum. More particularly on English ERN
011-6897
This particular individual also was known by the name
Met.
He talks about my client Nguyen Chia. No problem.
Now
let me get back to the oldest son of Nim. You didn't know whether he was married. But let me follow up on this.
Did you know
the former chief of the East Song, Sao Pim? With your leave, Mr. President, I would also like to show a photo someone who is of Sao Pim.
It is E3/R,
and it is a still from a film at
1:24.
Please leave it on the screen.
Mr. Witness, the person with the hat, with the cap all the way on the left, do you recognize him? That begs the question, whether you know the person standing next to the person on the left? Have you never seen Pol Pot before?
Look, my dad flop khơi Pol Pot pi mun te rư ka chang mai.
Ot da khơi.
Very well.
Chang mun avai te no te.
Let me see if I can try it differently, move on to the next subject. Mr. Witness, this person Hum, one former deputy chief of the General Staff of the Northwest Zone, testified, as I said, in this courtroom. He talked about Chiel's
marriage with
daughter of Sao Pim, the person that you just saw on the photo on the left. He also gave an interview to British filmmaker Robert Lemkin,
Every 4 or 5 months, his daughter and son-in-law. Let me return to Sao Pim's daughter and son getting married in August 75. That is on English ERN 0115603 and Khmer 0116847. This is again Toad's interview with British filmmaker Robert Lemkin.
Here,
Toad is speaking about he going to the marriage in 1975 in the East, marriage of Sao Pim's daughter. Do you recall bringing him to the wedding of his son, or have you ever heard of colleagues
No problem. Now let me move to the subject that we are most interested in. Do you recall escorting Tanim to Phnom Den Mountain?
ដាក់ជូនផង
Well, that is an interesting answer.
Và chỉ trong lời mới đại của chạp ở lòng.
Nhóm đã chung cái tôi tới nhóm con để cắt tập nông đánh nhóm đại xa kết hồi nè cào đặt tay nó để cái bạc chớp và nhóm bạc làn tao đặt bọt bò thì kiện nhỏ máu còn để chầm vẫn cái nhóm ở nhóm bạc nhưng mà vành máu khó áo
well Let me go right to it, Mr. Witness, and let me see if I can refresh your memory.
It was only 3 years ago that you told the investigators the following.
E3/9581, Mr. President, question and answer 3 and 4. I used to escort Da Nim to Phnom Den Mountain, which is bordered by Vietnam. Let me cut off there. Here, Mr. Witness, you said that you used to escort Da Nim to Phnom Den Mountain. Is that correct?
Trong trâu đại rực tế.
Hát ư.
The question that follows is from the investigators. Why did you escort Da Nim to Phnom Den Mountain? He needed me to secure him while he was transporting military uniforms from Phnom Den Mountain to Ampil Prahong in Sisaphon from 1977. Sisaphon
was also used as military base.
Does that refresh your memory, Mr. Witness?
Can you tell me more
about that? Nhóm sau đặt ngày phán là lâu rồi, thì mình phải phiền ấy.
Well, then I'm happy I was able to refresh your memory.
Nhóm sẽ bài chất đặt nhóm ai cho luôn nó khơi là quên lục sản
xây. What do you remember about you and Da Nim going to Phnom Den Mountain
in order to
transport military uniforms.
ខ្ញុំអត់នឹកឃើញអ្វីខ្លះដែរទៅខ្ញុំអត់នឹកឃើញមកដឹកថាចន្ទដឹកអីវ៉ាន់មកគាត់ដឹងតោណានេះដឹងកាលពេលគាត់ជិនអោយជួយជិតគាត់ផងខ្ញុំឆ្ងាយពីគាត់គេអាពីផ្សេងជិនគាត់នឹងខ្ញុំក្រៅគាត់ទីទី 2
Where is Phnom Den Mountain?
Ta Phnom Den nơi cái lai na đài lục xã xây.
Nhóm tranh chốt mắt đằng đó, nhóm. Cả kê nó chứa là pháo nhóm đài máu, nó chứa là mọi mùi kê đó, nhóm máu.
But surely you know where it was approximately. Where were those Phnom Den mountains?
Phnom Den mountains.
Well, we looked it up on the map. It is indeed close to the Vietnamese border. It used to be the southwest zone. When was it that you and others went together with Tan Nim to pick up military uniforms from the Phnom Penh Mountains? I understand that you did it at night time, but when was it? Was it in 1976? Was it in the first half of 1978?
Năm chết sập chết chuột bay pel còn lại đất nó một đằng nam na rồi chết pel bay bạc ngồi lên này bộ cái chồi máu bắt đầu bay bây giờ trọc bây giờ phù bóng
Was it the end of 77 or was it in the middle of 77? Is that something that you can recall? Was there already fighting going on with Vietnamese troops on the border?
Nhóm ổn nó chỉ chuẩn thơ ấy phóng để Việt Nam chô nó
In that same WRI and that same answer that I just referred to, you said that Tan Nim did not go often to Phnom Penh Mountain. He went there once in a long while. What does that mean? Did Tan Nim and yourself go to Phnom Penh Mountain to pick up military uniforms? Was it once, two times, five times? Do you remember?
Còn là tao nhưng mà đừng có tao mà đo đừng dép ra nhóm đừng là đất áo sao mà đo nó nắng gần phải là cá thế mới tạm nhóm gần rồi đi luôn nó nhóm bảy gật đâu cho việc nằm chết chết bay chết bay lên bay nó
What kind of military uniforms were you transporting from Phnom Penh Mountain at the border with Vietnam all the way in the southwest zone and back to the northwest zone, Sisophon? What kind of uniforms were they?
Ai than Việt Nam khiu khiu
and can you give an estimate as to how many uniforms Were you transported from the Vietnamese border back to the Northwest Zone? How do you know they were Vietnamese uniforms? You just described them, but were there any other circumstances that made you observe
and conclude that these were Vietnamese uniforms?
I understand. But what made you say that the uniforms were originating from Vietnam?
វិមានសំអាងអ្វីដែលនាំឲ្យលោកទៅតែនិយាយបាញ់មិញថាគាត់ឲ្យនឹងគឺថាវិមានប្រភពចេញមកពីវៀតណាមភពនឹងចាញ់ដល់នឹងគាត់ខ្ញុំមានទៅចិត្តគាត់ផងនឹងទៅឲ្យវាបាញ់អត់សូវដឹងដែរ
Do you know why it was that Runin himself, being the chief of the Northwest Zone, went personally all the way to the border with Vietnam to pick up Vietnamese uniforms and bring them back to the military base at Sisophon in his office at Ampil Prahung? Why was it that Runin himself went along?
And
what did he say? What did you hear? Do you remember how many cars were involved in the transport?
I presume you
driving the white jeep. Were there other cars? And if yes, how many?
There were other cars. There were other cars. There were other cars. There were other cars.
There were other cars. There were other
And the uniforms were put in that truck. Should that be my understanding?
Tam khom sdap to khom yul tha ai santhan ke yo mo dak no knong lan thum nong men te.
Ba.
And did you yourself assist the loading of those uniforms into the GMC truck?
Lok ptoal khluon lok ptoal nang ban chuoy leuk dak ឯក សន្តាន យោធា នឹង ដាក់ ទៅ ចូល ក្នុង ឡាន CMZ នឹង ដែរ ទេ
អត់ ទេ គេ ដាក់ ក្នុង គេ យក ឲ្យ មក ឲ្យ ដូរ កម្លាំង គ្នា គេ ឲ្យ យើង ចូល ទៅ
Why were you not allowed?
Mẹ tự vì cho hai đấy bàn chơi game mình ở nhà đây lột chùi lột đá.
Thì nhóm đầu cào nó còn đầu còn lại như thế và cái dù làm thật đất nó coi trong trầm đang hút bán thì đất cũng tiêu dùng máu thì một cũng mua đồng với bàn chân mình đang máu dùng sâu để màu không bình nhâm đại mọi thế cũng cười không đất dùng áo nhóm giúp bạc máu.
Can you describe for us a bit how the
transport
went?
Which route did you take?
Were there many stops on the way? Were you checked at checkpoints by other military guys? Did they look inside the trucks? Can you describe for us a bit how that particular transport went? What does 32 stand for?
May the way lay Sam Sapi, no, lay Sam Sapi, the man, or a dello.
That lake land, you know, that lake land, Sam Sapi.
I'm not quite sure if I understood you correctly. Did you say that you yourself went at night and that Nhim went during the day? Is that what you said?
Dù cho một đoàn đã chậm cực thế, mà sau đằng mà vắng. Thì rồi ta khuyên bài một cất đã chậm một cực.
Do you remember who was driving him when he went with you
and others to the Khmer Mountain?
Do you know, was it one of your colleagues who was driving him?
Tạm biệt lúc, cả đồng tàu rồi bỏ lúc nữa, nẹ ná chiên nẹ bạc bò rồi bỏ con.
Mà chụp, hóa ra chụp chụp, thật được chụp, hóa chụp.
And was it Tanim who went first and
you and
the truck came afterwards, or was it the other way around? I observed that the witness was discussing with his standby counsel. I have no problem with that, but
if there's something that should be known to the parties, that would be the moment I'm supposed to say.
You want him to say what he said to his counsel?
I skipped the question is
if the witness is all right,
quite nervous, maybe there is
something wrong. Of course, I don't want to know what was advised on the content, but if there is something we should know, this would be an appropriate time.
Look, sir, say. Look, try time some more about look me to be. Hi, look, come from the client. ให้ลูกมินสุดชลาย away the look, ban cham chong cham belong mauna. Sum chuin.
Chia dây này dây để chụp một vật nhưng mà đồ chất pì to và to mà nó nhưng nó có chóp co nhầm nó có đau một lái cái lái sau chụp cái món
lúc xa xây xung lúc lời ở lia lia đánh đánh lúc cũng khai ấy ngon tại đôi lúc gì nữa tiếc nhỉ
đi nữa ở trong dây một hạt đấy nhỉ à giờ bật quạt nhỉ trong
hạt lúc mịt ví lúc xua sầm nua mà đòn tiết hay lúc xạ sấy chăm sắt đắp sầm nua bỏ lúc mịt ví đòi vô cho tục đại cho bà lo hạ tạm bây nguồn lực cả tròn trăm bỏ lúc.
I was so concerned with this, Mr. President, I actually forgot my question. But it is maybe also an appropriate time considering the break now.
Can I just follow up on the counselor's witness? Are you sick? Are you feeling sick?
Or are you okay?
Nervous. For a witness, not unusual, yes.
That is correct. Let me ask one final question before the break, Mr. Witness. Would you prefer that we continue in a closed session?
Look,
Maybe I could also request duty counsel to discuss the phenomenon of closed session with his client, and then after the break, Mr. President, we could, if necessary, revisit that issue.
I just want to object to this idea that counsel suggests to a witness we go into closed session. There are very specific rules for when we go into closed session. They're based on very distinct factual situations. This is a public proceeding. There is an interest in that, and unless there's a demonstrated reason for closed session, we don't do that. And I don't think counsel can just suggest to a witness
Oui, il s'agit d'une autre question et c'est une requête que j'aurais à faire pour la défense de Nunchia. J'ai dû comprendre, Maître Copé, que vous aviez localisé sur une carte où était Phnom Penh. Est-ce qu'il vous serait possible de verser cette carte au dossier
ou autrement peut-être l'annexer au transcript,
je voudrais être sûr qu'on comprenne bien de quoi il s'agit, peut-être même présenter cette carte témoin, je ne sais pas. Je ne sais pas s'il existe d'autres Phnom Penh, Phnom Penh encore. Je ne sais pas s'il existe d'autres Phnom Penh, Phnom Penh encore.
No problem. Thank you, Mr. President.
in response to that too, last week I believe it was, my colleague, the deputy prosecutor, Mr. Smith, introduced a Cambodia roadmap. I looked at that yesterday, and you can see down on there, it's a very well-known border crossing down in Khmer. So I'm not sure whether that is in evidence, whether it's been put on Xylem or not, but it, you can see the location on that map.
I believe the roadmap has been admitted into evidence. I
haven't looked at that particular map, but there is only one Phnom Dan on
the ground. But the key back young John Hanjan, the Kopontan knows of Kamani Phnom Dan the Moody.
ឥឡូវដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអង្គជំនះប្រកាសសម្រាប់20នាទីគឺចាប់ពីនេះតទៅសូមជឿសម្រាប់
សូមជឿក្រុមឈរ